i.e. could the amount of debt servicing be reduced? If at T12, 12 months after acquisition, once cash flows are coming through, there was a commercial paper traded market available, they would not have to pay K plus 3 for the commercial paper short-term amount that they needed, i.e. enhanced OD. They could have issued that at a much cheaper cost. Furthermore, if there was a market for securitization of receivables, they could have got that also issued, and that could have been traded in the capital markets. And finally, if an options market was available, the convertible bond could have been stripped in terms of its call and put options and traded separately, and that could further have reduced the cost to the company. Post the IPO, suppose a situation arose where, which is actually very near the actual reality, the company by 2014 is able to generate 40% of revenues from exports. Now, you have a situation here where the company can substantially reduce its costs through a swap arrangement between a local currency and a foreign currency swap. Let's give a live example here. Asad Umar is not here, but I would have said that Engro is a company which went in for 14% long-term debt and very successfully actually raised it. It was a stable business. Everybody knows fertilizer is very profitable. However, Engro all of a sudden faced very uncertain reality. Sui Northern stopped giving it gas. It basically broke the promise. And being a government entity, there's only so much Engro can do. So all of a sudden, Engro is faced with a situation where it is paying 14% fixed rate on a very uncertain environment. Also in a macro situation where we are expecting that the overall interest rate structure is beginning to come down a little bit. On the other hand, you have this company, which is generating 40% of its revenues in dollars. Engro, in financing its big expansion, has taken on a huge dollar loan. And let us assume for a minute that the cost of the loan in dollar terms is 6.5% to 7%. We are seeing or expecting the rupee devaluation to be in the range of about 9% to 10% per annum over the next 2 to 3 years. That means Engro is going to have to cough out 17% on its long-term loans. This company, on the other hand, is paying about 12.5%, 13% on its long-term loans. What happens? Suppose Engro and this company get together and they swap the cash flows of the interest payments. This company says to Engro that, okay, I have to give 12% anyway. You give my 12% to the holders of my debt, and I will pay the holders of your debt 7% in terms of the foreign currency component. All of a sudden, this company reduces its debt servicing by 400 basis points. Engro is able to reduce its debt servicing by 250 to 300 basis points, which is a substantial amount. Even if it does that on 2 billion rupees equivalent, it is a substantial amount. So these are the kind of structures that are available, and as CFOs, we need to explore. We cannot just rely on bankers bringing us the products, because they have not brought us the products, unfortunately. And given the fact that they are sitting on 6.5% spread, they're not unlikely to bring in products. So what has to happen is that the CFOs must take the initiative. In the capital markets, we are trying very hard to put together a structure where debt market component can become electronically tradable and therefore easily accessible to vast amount of corporates. We are working very closely with certain banks and investment banks, as well as talking to the State Bank, of looking at the possibility of creating market makers for publicly traded debt, which would increase the liquidity and allow your TFCs to be easily accessible to the market. So at the end of the day, the kind of things that we need to do is a bit out of the box, but we should start thinking about it, because the world is changing, and if we do not do that, we'll limit our horizon to very old traditional methodologies of financing. And therefore, perhaps, in a globalized world, limit our own ability to grow and prosper. Putable bonds, convertible, exchangeable, floating rate notes, caps and floors, swaps, and swaptions, which is options on swaps, which is one stage further than swaps. It goes into the derivatives of swaps. These are the things which I think allows us to look at financing options and more complex structures which can help us grow and get your return on equity that you deserve. With that, I'll just take your leave. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, please shoot.
Just one moment. Here we are. Thank you so much. First question. Thank you.
Mr. Naqvi, just for the record, this is Uzma Adil from Sui Northern Gas. For the record, I just want to put it straight that Sui Northern did not default or did not break its promise. It was just a force majeure position. So Engro was not supplied gas, not due to any promises being broken. It was just for the record.
Thank you very much. Taken.
We have some more questions. One over the other side, sir.
Excuse me, sir. My question is, what are you doing for small individuals for guidance, for their guidance? In fact, there is nothing available on your site which guide the individual how to invest or how to make risk valuations.
Sorry, I did not catch your question. Is it regarding the current topic or are you asking separately regarding what the stock market is doing about individuals?
Separately regarding the stock market.
I see. A couple of things are underway. First of all, it is a great pleasure for me to also announce, and you would also know that the Parliament has passed the demutualization bill of the stock market last week. This is equivalent to the big bang in financial markets that happened in England about 20 years ago. I think the entire structure of the securities industry is going to change over the next 6 months. What will happen, first of all, is that the stock exchanges are all going to get corporatized and they are going to get listed on the stock exchanges themselves. They will be then run as private sector for-profit companies where the management of the exchange will be separated from the membership of the exchange. I believe that this will create tremendous amount of transparency and it will also provide the management the freedom to give investors the kind of guidance and protection as well as comfort that is needed. You will see changes happening in that regard. In terms of specific things that have been done recently, what has happened is that the National Clearing Company of Pakistan and the Central Depository Company have now started a service whereby any movement in your account is immediately SMS to you or emailed to you, so that the problems which faced people with brokers using up their shares for their own purposes cannot happen now. Or if they happen, they can be immediately detected. Second is that the stock exchange has raised the limit of payouts for those people who needed compensation from defaulted brokers in the 2008 crisis from about 25 million to 75 million. And as I speak, we have paid out more than 450 million rupees. excuse me. Out of which 50% of the claimants have gotten 100% return of their investment. At the same time, we have put in a very, very strict know your customer anti-money laundering regime, which the brokers now have to abide with. We have created a totally new audit division that is going to do spot audit of brokers. So the regime has been tightened. We will be launching, along with SECP, a very, very comprehensive awareness generation program whereby we are not looking at just the stock market. I think one of the problems as far as financing and fundraising in Pakistan has been that the average saver has not been really educated or made aware that investing is a small part of overall financial planning. And that goes with your life cycle. If you're 35 years old, you have a certain structure of debt and equity and net worth. If you're 45, it is another structure, and therefore your needs and requirements for investment are very different. So this scheme is also going to be put forward.
Sure, we have lots of questions coming, so thank you so much for staying with us. And we probably got about 8 minutes, so please, quite direct questions. We're absolutely thrilled. Mr. Naqvi is going to be here. Sir, your question, and then we're going back down to the back of the room. Sir.
My question is,